When I first started working, I worked for Warner's. I signed my contract when I was 17, so my folks had to co-sign. My first film at Disney was The Emperor's New Groove, and that was fun because the character that I worked on, Kuzco, he goes from being a human to a llama, so it's almost like you get a two-in-one. When you start on a film, the director will give us the pitch. You know, this scene is, the llama dancing or whatever, and I want him to dance this way. And dancing is extremely hard to do because you're dealing with a human moving in a way, and people are gonna look at it and recognize if it adds up or not. So you basically have to take your stick figure and work out all the moves to make it unique to the character. You think about, well, when Kuzco's coming out on stage, how would he do it? Is he stuck up? Would he like doing this? Would he enjoy having the attention of everyone in the kingdom? You may try and figure it out and translate it, and you've done it so straight that it doesn't work. When you see it on the film, it looks flat. It doesn't work somehow, and you have to take that move and exaggerate it much more than you ever thought you would. But then it works. I often find that when I'm animating a scene, I put myself into the scene, and every animator does this. And we'll be sitting in the theater, watching the week's work, and even if the name didn't come up, you could tell your coworker's work. Because a lot of times, it'll look like them. It'll have their expressions. It'll have their physical quirks, you know. It'll walk like them. It'll talk like them. It'll, you know, do their hand motions. And you just end up putting yourself in the scene. About once a week, I'll take my scene to the directors and show my scene. And usually you'll show it in two stages. You'll show the rough, which is the stick figure version. And then you'll show the tie-down, which is the polished drawings. And when you show it the second time, that's the main approval to be put into the film.
And I love the thing you did with the tail, using this, you know, like a finger snap.
Mm-hmm. I don't feel like being a woman is an issue. You basically show your scene, and if the work is there, it's there. And you're judged on that. And I love that. I enjoy that very much. I think animating is probably about half art and half craft. I think the thing that is very important is to keep the art with the craft and to try and make it a beautiful thing, to make it so that you don't even realize that the craft is there, so that you can watch this animation and you think that it lives. And once you have done that, then that is the highest achievement in animation. Then you can call yourself an animator.